Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. I hope you are doing well. I just wanted to make a quick little video before Christmas. And I was thinking a lot of people seem to have trouble to understand how primary color method work to build a skin tone. A lot of people seem very confused about how we achieve a skin tone without using the skin flesh, the flesh color that came with a lot of paint kit like Genesis or Reborn FX. So I was thinking I may just do a quick reminder of how the color work. I'm sure you, many of you have had some art class in school when you were young about the color. But I will just make a quick reminder of the color and show you how to mix them and which result you will get with that. First, you must understand that your kit came in different color. Usually they already have a flesh color to them. They are never totally white. Even the paler are kind of colored with the flesh color. So this one is from Bountiful Baby. It's one of the palest kit you can have. It's really pale, but it's not totally white. You can have something like that, just a bit darker than the Bountiful Baby kit. And you may have something very orange in color, just to see the difference. So when you build your skin tone, you have to keep in mind that your kit will give your final result a color already. And you will have to play with that to achieve the skin tone you like. It's very hard to get pale skin tone, pale Caucasian skin tone with a darker kit like this. It's possible, but it's harder with the primary method. But you can totally achieve this with a kit paler. I hope it's clear. And please excuse my fingers. I have done some bat pump with my daughter, and the dye is very, very strong, and I can't remove it. So I'm stuck with pink fingers for Christmas. So I have already prepared some color with a bit of water, unequally water, and I will use a paper sheet to show you. First, I will do the primary color, and then I will show you with different tint, different shade. So I have the cyan, primary cyan. I have the primary yellow. I don't have the primary red, but I have a pyrrole red. It's really close to the primary red. So you know that when you mix your three primary color, you will get other color, the secondary color. So if I mix yellow with blue, I will get green. And if I mix red with yellow, I will get orange. My red is very strong, but it's orange. And if I mix blue with red, I will get purple. And then if you mix those secondary colors together, you will get brown. So if I mix green with orange and purple, I will get a brown. It's the same if you mix, for example, you have green and then you add just red to the green, you will have a brown. It will be a different brown, but it's brown. The thing is, you can play with those colors to get the type of green, purple, orange, or brown you want. If you add little more blue to this brown, you will have a more dark brown. If you add a little more green than the red, you understand that you can get different shade of brown with different ratio of color that you mix. So when you use the primary method, what it means is you take your kit and you add layer of yellow, very translucent. Then you can add a layer of blue, very translucent. And then I have to rinse my my brush. You add a layer of red over it, very translucent. Then yellow again, blue again. You will get your brown with this method. And the skin is brown. Even if you are Caucasian or Asian or African or any ethnicities, your skin is brown. Your skin is brown, but different shade of brown. So to achieve the skin tone you want, you will just have to play with the different color to get the shade you want. If you want more of a strawberry tint, strawberry rosy pink pink skin tone, you will use less yellow and more of the red and the blue to keep it a bit more purple. If you want more a peach skin tone, you will add more yellow and red and a bit less of blue to get a more orange tint. I hope it's clear that you can understand what I mean. And you can totally paint a kit with only one layer of yellow and a lot of layer of blue and red. That's totally fine. You can do just a more olive skin tone with more yellow and blue and just a little bit of red. You have to get the three colors to get a nice skin tone, except if your kit is already dark, like I showed you in the beginning. If it's a kit that is already very dark, you can skip the yellow and go just with red and blue. And that is the primary color method. You don't have to be afraid. You will not need any flesh, already made flesh color to achieve the skin tone. The only thing we don't use in this method is the white. We don't need the white because our colors are very, very, very dilute. And the color of the kit will show through it. And every color along the way will show through it. And you will not need to add any white to that to get a nice skin tone. And you can mix your color. You can make your brown with mixing the three colors together and use a layer of this brown. It will make the thing the process a bit faster, but you will have a bit less control over the kind of skin tone you will you like. It's harder if you want to keep a peach skin tone if you use your color mixed. It's often better to use your color separately and adjust as your progress is going. You can adjust if you think your kit is a bit too red. You can skip the red, add more yellow and blue. So you can totally use that. You can totally use a layer of green on your kit or a layer of orange on your kit. There's no trouble to doing that. It's still the primary color method, even if you use green or purple or orange on your kit. There is still the primary color. And if you use different blue, yellow, and red, you will get different results too. I made a diarylide yellow, ultramarine blue, and cadmium red. As you can see, those are really different. They are not the same blue, the same yellow. And if you play with that, you can get different results. My water is really disgusting. It will show you a different green. You see? With those blue and yellow, I got something that looks more like a sap green or olive green, maybe. I really like this color on the kit. Gives a really nice glow. And if you want to see, I have sap green here. Just so you can see the similarity. You see, if I add a little bit more blue, I can have something really, really close. And if I use this blue with this red, I will get another type of purple. And if I add more blue, we'll get something darker. Very nice for the eyelid. It's really, really close to the eyelid purple. If I go with an orange, I have more of a peach orange with that. It's very nice color for mottling. I will just redo my green in the primary color. You will see the difference. That's a different green, totally different green. More like a phthalo green. And if I do a purple, with the primary, you see that it's a very, very dark, dark purple. It's not the same. Same thing for the orange. Orange is very similar. So you can totally play with those colors to get the color you want. You can mix the three colors together, get a nice brown. Usually I do my green, then I add a bit of red in my green to get a nice brown. Then you add this brown to your red and you get a blood type color. Try to make a brown. It's easier on a palette. You see, if I just add a little bit of this brown, I get a bloody red. It's perfect for the blushing. Perfect for mottling too. If you want to add, to do your vein, I really like the Primary Cyan for the vein. You can add just a little touch of yellow. You will add a kind of a blue green to do your vein. So you can play all you want with those colors. You can use yellow ochre to try. You can use I have this blue here, phthalo blue with green shade. You can use cobalt blue. You can use any kind of red that you have in hand, and you will get all the possibilities to do your crease, to do your blushing, to do your undertones, your vein, your mottling, and it will build your skin tone little by little. The skin tone is really built with wash of your primary color, very, very well dilute, very translucent, one layer over another layer. That will give you the transparency that you need to complete, to achieve a skin tone that you like. Just with three colors you can achieve a nice realism in your kit. So I really hope that it's clear and that you understand now how the primary color method work. I almost never use white except for the nails, or if I want to achieve newborn hands and feet with a little bit of purple and a pink, light pink. It's very rare that I use white. So with that, I'm sure you will be able to understand what you are doing, understand what I do when I do my tutorial, all the color works together, And don't be afraid to create your own mix. You can keep your mix a while in a little container like this, or this kind of bottle. You can keep it a while if you pre-mix your color with water and medium. Try different things, play with it. Give it a try with the green and the purple as layer to your kit or as mottling, and you will soon realize all the nice effects you can get with those color. And I wish you a very nice, very happy holidays. I wish you Merry Christmas and Happy New Year, and we hope that next year will be better and happier than this one, we hope. So that's all for me today. Please subscribe. I know I don't do a lot of English video, but I try my best to do some from time to time. So please subscribe. You can put a like if you want, and comment. I like to read your comment, and I really like to respond to your question. So don't be afraid, and you can add a comment. So have a good day, a great day. See you soon. Goodbye.